TNA. Sometimes if I'm being honest, feels like it's only me. Notably, notably, but I have it right if you're quoting me. Write my name on your hit list, it might be the last time you wrote something. Rip that cocky smile right off your face for thinking you're close to me. Grab a can of gasoline, light it all over your self-esteem. Selfishly watching y'all helplessly pretend you're on my planet. Shoot you out of the sky like your punch lined you a knot, landing gun jamming, reach in your mouth and rip out your tongue after tongue lashing. I hand them out like pamphlets in church. Pastor, show up to my funeral wearing all black and what's happening. I look around and wonder where my fans at. Oh Lord, they know me so well, they know I'm not in that casket trash bag. Absurd, very disturbed, stare at the earth like this is not the place I was birthed.
All right, coming up next, it is a welterweight showdown between Colton Chaos Covington and George Rush St. Pierre. Well, huge buzz for this fight. Round one is now underway. Classic style in progress there between a grappler and a 5-2 player type, but certainly more well-rounded fighter.
No, he doesn't mind grappling, but he also has the ability to fight on the feet. Something that grappler is not really good at doing. He seems to be behind the eight ball a little bit, but let's see how he manages getting this fight to the ground.
Perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick.
He's using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC. Good series of punches by him there. He has been busy throughout.
He's doing a great job with the hands. He looks like a professional boxer out there.
Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Covington. GSP gets caught by that straight punch there. That strike caught by George St. Pierre.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks. Big leg kick lands under the elbow. Nice punch lands over the top.
Nice jab there by Covington. He's a guy who can allow you with pace and pressure, whether he's wrestling or striking.
Yeah, but it's his call to call, right? His call to call is for him to really dictate the
movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground side.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Covington's has got full mount now. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire.
Jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle. Watch triangle, watch triangle. Move, 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 control, control.
Nicely done. All right, close guard now. 30 seconds now to go in the round.
Blasted. do that, most times you go block a shot that's incoming.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Seconds to go round two. All right, working inside the closed guard.
Now the guy's got on bar. He's attacking it on him.
Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell. So back to the stool. Mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight.
That was awesome. I need more of that. I want you to go out of the...
You ready?
Third and final round. Well, looks as though his leg is hurt here. You can even see him moving a little bit. Beautiful right punch. Follows it up with the left. Showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Oh, nice straight punch there. Must be nice to have a reach advantage like this. Oh!
What a fantastic strike to go at the exact right.
Oh! Oh, he might be out. Striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. never know where he's going to be.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC.
He got his foot on the hip, and now he's throwing up a triangle attempt. He's going to try to move his left arm across to get pressure on the choke.
So he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
St. Pierre's lower jaw now trying to show Dr. Sloan. 15 seconds. All right, side control now. So the fight goes the distance. We'll take a look back at the action, but should go his way given all he got done in the striking game.
Yeah, he did a great job of landing at will, mixing up the target, doing everything that he's become known for in order to cruise to a very good decision.
The official decision is now in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score the contest 29-28. Declaring the winner by unanimous decision, Colby Chaos Covington.
Oh.